Ahead is Lucas Oil Stadium, the home stadium of the NFL's Indianapolis Colts. But the story of how Indianapolis got the Colts is one of the most bizarre episodes in American sports history, and honestly, one of the greatest heists ever executed. Our story begins in the city of Baltimore, Maryland. For 30 years, beginning in 1953, the Baltimore Colts experienced a lot of football success. They won three NFL championships and won Super Bowl V in 1970, endearing them to the people of Charm City. But little did everybody know, trouble was on the way. In comes our central character to this story, Robert Irsay, who in 1971 acquired the Baltimore Colts after doing a franchise trade with then-owner Carol Rosenblum, who received the LA Rams. Like many sports relocations in the past 40 years, the big issue came down to the stadium. The Baltimore Colts played in Memorial Stadium, which was a dilapidated stadium that they shared with the Orioles. Some of the notable features included 10,000 seats with obstructed views, and 20,000 of the seats were benches without backs. A new modern stadium was proposed, called the Balto Dome. The building costs were estimated at $78 million. However, funding could not be secured after Baltimore citizens voted against public funds going into the building of a sports arena. On February 27, 1974, Maryland's governor, Marvin Mandel, pulled the plug on the idea. On the surface, Robert Irsay stated that he wanted to keep the Colts in Baltimore. But for the next 10 years, he actively looked for a city to move the team, including Phoenix, Indianapolis, Memphis, Jacksonville, New York, and Birmingham. Now let's head to Annapolis, the state capital of Maryland. In 1980, Irsay proposed a plan to the Maryland legislature for a $25 million renovation to Memorial Stadium. The Maryland legislature responded with a $23 million funding contingent on the Colts and Orioles signing long-term leases, which neither team was willing to do. On March 2, 1984, NFL owners voted to give Irsay permission to move his franchise to the city of his choosing. This led to a panic in the Maryland state legislature, leading to a plot to utilize the most extreme measure possible, the seizure of the Baltimore Colts by eminent domain. And on March 27, 1984, the Maryland Senate voted 38-4 to give Baltimore the power to seize the Colts from Robert Irsay. Irsay was running out of options, and he had to act fast. And act fast, he did. On the night of March 28, 1984, Robert Irsay made a call to the mayor of Indianapolis, William Hutnut, and told him he was taking their deal. Knowing that the time was limited, Hutnut reached out to his neighbor and friend John B. Smith, who just so happened to be the CEO of the moving company Mayflower Transit. The company immediately dispatched 15 large moving trucks to the Colts headquarters in Owings Mills, Maryland. The trucks moved under the cover of darkness, and an army of movers packed and loaded the entire organization onto the trucks. However, fearing the Maryland State Police would block a 15-truck convoy, the trucks split up, and each took a different route to Indianapolis. As each truck reached Indiana, the Indiana State Police met it and escorted it to Indianapolis, a process repeated until all 15 trucks had reached the destination. The next morning on March 29, 1984, Mayor Hutnut called a press conference to announce that the Colts had moved to Indianapolis. This move stunned the city of Baltimore and broke the hearts of its fans and citizens, leading to widespread backlash, including the boycott of Mayflower Transit. The Colts played their first game in Indy on September 2, 1984, in a 23-14 loss to the New York Jets. In December of 1985, a U.S. District Court judge threw out the lawsuit which sought to return the team to Maryland. Though the city of Baltimore was allowed to keep the Vince Lombardi trophy that the Colts won in Super Bowl V, today the Colts are valued at $3.8 billion, which is why I believe this is the greatest heist of all time. However, there is a major twist to this story, because Baltimore itself would steal an NFL team when in 1996, Art Modell, the owner of the Cleveland Browns, moved the team to Baltimore and rebranded them as the Baltimore Ravens. These Baltimore Ravens won a Super Bowl before the Colts did and have won two Super Bowls to the Colts' one. While not as fierce as it used to be, there will always be a healthy level of hate between these two franchises. But whose side are you on? Let us know in the comments section. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. If you'd like to see a full city tour of Indianapolis, click the video on your screen right now.